Good morning, Vandana. Today we are going to discuss about the problems on EMF equation and ideal transformer on no load and operation of transformer on load without leakage impedance of the coil. Okay, in the previous class, we are deriving about the EMF equation of a transformer and the problem that will be related to the EMF equation. Okay, we are solving one problem that will be related to the EMF equation. Now in the present class, okay, we are solving the problems that will be related to the EMF equation and also the ideal transformers. Okay, first coming to the first problem, a single phase transformer has 400 primary and 1000 secondary turns. Okay, first write down the given data. What is the number of turns? What is the indication for that number of turns? That is N1. Okay, therefore, N1 is equal to the 400 and N2 is equal to 1000. Okay, therefore, N1 is equal to the 400 and N2 is equal to 1000 number of turns. And also the net cross-sectional area. Okay, therefore, the net cross-sectional area is 60 centimeters square. Okay, therefore, the net cross-sectional area is 60 centimeters square. Okay, then the area A is equal to 60 centimeters square. Cross-sectional area, that is 60 centimeters square. Okay, the primary winding B connected to the 50 hedges. That is F is equal to 50 hedges. Okay, what is the F supply frequency? That is equal to 50 hedges. Okay, next, supply, AC supply voltage is, that is 520 volts. Okay, therefore, the supply voltage is 520 volts. That is equal to V is equal to 520. V is equal to 520 volts. First, calculate the peak value of flux density. Okay, that means flux density. Okay, what is the formula for flux density? That is B max. Okay, flux means the phi and flux density is the B max. Okay, next, the voltage induced in the secondary winding. Okay, what is the voltage that will be induced in the secondary winding? That is Q2, E2. Okay, EMF induced in the secondary winding is E2. Okay, these are the two terms that will be determined from this given data. First of all, we calculate the transformation ratio, that is K. Okay, therefore, what is the formula for transformation ratio, that is K? K is equal to N2 by N1. Okay, understand ma? K is equal to N2 by N1, where N2 is the number of turns in the secondary winding and N1 is the number of turns in the primary winding. We calculate the K value, that is equal to 1000 by 400, that is equal to 2.5. Okay, next we calculate the E2 by E1. Okay, the formula, another formula is there for the transformation ratio K. Therefore, K is equal to E2 by E1. K is equal to E2 by E1. Okay, by using this formula, we calculate the E2. Okay, by using this formula, we are writing the E2 is equal to K into E1. Okay, we are write down E2 is equal to K into E1. Okay, therefore, E1 is the EMF induced in the, E1 is EMF induced in the primary winding and E2 is the EMF induced in the secondary winding. That will be determined term. Okay, this is the second bit. Okay, what is the second bit? The voltage induced in the secondary winding. Okay, E2 is the voltage induced in the secondary winding. Therefore, E2 is equal to K into E1, where K is equal to 2.5 and E1 is equal to 520. E1 equal to V. Okay, then it is equal to 520. Okay, then we obtain the E2 value, that is 1300 volts. Okay, then we obtain the E2 value, that is 1300 volts. Okay, next, what is the first bit flux density? Okay, the flux density is there in the formula of EMF equation. Okay, what is the formula for EMF equation? That is E1. Okay, therefore, E1 is equal to, okay, the formula for EMF equation, that is E1 is equal to 4.44 F. F is the supply frequency, N1 into 5. Okay, normally the EMF equation of a transformer is E1 is equal to 4.44 F, N1 into 5. Where F is the supply frequency. Okay, understand my F is the supply frequency. And N1 is the number of turns in the primary winding. And phi is the flux. Okay, therefore, the phi will be equal to the phi M into B. BM into A. Therefore, phi is equal to BM into A. Okay, we are substituting instead of phi, we are taking as BM into A. Okay, that is this formula. Okay, therefore, E1 is equal to 4.44 F N1 BM into A. Okay, understand ma? Where BM into A is the, okay, therefore, BM into A is the phi. Okay, phi is the flux. And BM is the flux density and A is the area of cross section. Okay, therefore, how we will be obtained the flux? Okay, flux density into cross sectional area. Okay, flux density into cross sectional area. Okay, by substituting all these values and then we obtain the BM, that is the maximum flux. Okay, by substitute all these values and then we obtain the BM, that is the maximum flux density. Okay, the units for flux density is Webers per meter square. Okay, the units for flux is Webers. The units for flux is Webers. And the units for flux density is Webers per meter square. Okay, understand ma? Webers per meter square. Next, coming to the second problem. Explain the second problem. A 25 kilovolt ampere, a 25 kilovolt ampere KVA transformer has 500 turns on the primary and 50 turns on the secondary. Okay, the primary is connected to 3000 volts, 50 hedges supply. Okay, therefore, find the full load primary and secondary currents. Therefore, we are calculating the full load primary and secondary current. That means I1 and the I2. Okay, the secondary EMF and the maximum flux in the core. Okay, and also we are calculating the secondary EMF, that is E2, and neglect the voltage drop and the primary. Okay, maximum flux in the core. What is the maximum flux in the core? Okay, that is phi m. First, write down the given data. After that, we are calculating the values. First, the rating of transformer is 25 kilovolt ampere. Next, 500 turns on the primary. That means N1. Okay, number of turns means N1. Okay, therefore, N1 is equal to 500 turns and 50 turns on the secondary. That means N2. 50 turns on the secondary, that is N2. Okay, therefore N2 is equal to 50. The primary is connected to the 3000 volts 50 hedges supply. Therefore, V is equal to V is equal to 3000 volts and 50 hertz supply. F is equal to 50 hertz. Find the full load primary and the secondary currents. Find the full load primary is I1 current and the full load secondary current, that is I2. Okay, and then we find the full load primary and secondary currents, that is I1 and the I2. The secondary EMF, that means E2. Okay, what is the secondary EMF? That is E2. And maximum flux in the core. Okay, what is the maximum flux? That is phi m. Okay, these things will be calculated by using this given data. Okay, this is the calculated terms. Maximum flux, current in the primary and secondary winding, and EMF induced in the secondary winding. First, we calculate the K. Okay, what is the formula for K? K equal to N2 by N1. Okay, then we obtain K value. Okay, when we are calculating that K term, then first we calculate the I1. Okay, what is the formula for I1 normally? The power P. Okay, what is the formula for power P? V into I. P equal to V into I. KV means output power of a transformer, rating of a transformer. Therefore, power P equal to 25,000. K means kilo, that is 25,000. Okay, by using this equation, okay, we are writing the formula for I. Okay, therefore, I is equal to P by V. Therefore, I is equal to P by V. Okay, what is the formula for, what is the value for power? That is 25 kilovolts. That means 25,000. Power P equal to 25,000 by V. Okay, what is the voltage? That is 3000. Therefore, input voltage is equal to 3000. Then we obtain the I1 current. Okay, therefore, I1 is equal to 8.33 amperes. Okay, therefore, I1 is equal to 8.33 amperes. By using this I1 current, we calculate the I2. Okay, therefore, K is equal to 1 by I2. Okay, we are having the relation is there in the case of a transformer, that is K is equal to I1 by I2 equal to N2 by N1 is equal to E2 by E1 equal to E2 by E1 equal to I2 by Phi1. Okay, this is the relation for the transformation ratio K. Okay, remember this formula, this relation. Okay, by using this relation, okay, we calculate the I2. Okay, by using this relation, we calculate the I2. Therefore, I2 is equal to I1 by K. From this relation, we write down I2 equation, that is I2 equal to I1 by K. Okay, what is the I1 current? That is I1 is equal to 8.33. I1 equal to 8.33. And K is equal to 1 by 10. Okay, then we obtain I2 current is 83.3 amperes. Then we obtain I2 current equal to 83.3 amperes. Next, we calculate the EMF per turn. Okay, next we calculate the EMF per turn on the primary side. EMF per turn. EMF per turn means V by N1. Okay, EMF per turn is The formula for EMF per turn is EMF is V by turn. Turn means number of turns on primary side, that is N1. Per means division. Okay, EMF. Okay, what is the EMF? V. Per means division, turn on primary. Turn on primary means N1. Okay, we are substituting. What is the V value? 3000. Okay, what is the V value? 3000 by N1. Okay, what is the N1? That is 500. 3000 by 500 is equal to 6 volts. Okay, understand ma? Then the EMF per turn is equal to 6 volts. Next, we calculate the E2. EMF per turn into, okay, N2. How we will calculate the E2? Okay, we are having the formula is there, that is EMF per turn. R E2 is equal to EMF per turn into N2. EMF per turn into N2. R E1 equal to, we are having the formula is there, E1 is equal to EMF per turn EMF per turn into N1. EMF per turn into N1. Okay, this is the formulas for E1 and the E2. Okay, we already calculate the EMF per turn, that is 6 volts. Okay, then we calculate the E2. E2 equal to EMF per turn. Okay, what is the EMF per turn? 6 into N2. Okay, what is the N2? That is 50 turns. 50. Then we obtain the E2 value. E2 equal to K into E1. Or we are calculating another formula, that is E2 equal to K into E1. Okay, any formula we will be used for determining the E2. Next, we calculate the phi m. Okay, the formula for the phi m will be there in the formula of EMF equation. Okay, what is the EMF equation formula? E1. E1 is equal to 4.44 F N1 into phi m. Okay, therefore E1 is equal to 4.44. F is the supply frequency. Okay, understand me? What is the supply frequency? 50 hertz. And what is the N1? N1 is the number of turns. And what is the phi m? Phi m is the maximum flux. Okay, understand me? Phi m is the maximum flux. Okay, that is the EMF induced in the primary winding, that is E1. Okay, by using this E1, okay, we obtain the phi m value, that is the maximum flux. Okay, therefore phi m is equal to 27 milliwebers. Therefore the maximum flux is equal to 27 milliwebers. Okay, you understand ma? Next, ideal transformer at no load. First of all, what is meant by ideal transformer? We already discussed in the previous classes. Okay, ideal. Ideal means the perfect. There is no losses. Without obtaining the losses, we are doing the calculations. Okay, but it is not practically available, but only it will be assumptions calculated. It will be used only for the calculation purpose. Okay, first of all, what is meant by the ideal transformer means without losses. Okay, therefore, the efficiency for that ideal transformer is 100%, and there is no leakage core losses, and there is no any copper losses. Okay, therefore the input will be equal to the output. Okay, that is the ideal transformer. Okay, therefore that will be operated on no load. How it will be observed means a transformer is operating at no load is equivalent to the secondary wine is equivalent to the secondary winding, okay, kept open circuited, which means current in the secondary is zero. Okay, this is the ideal transformer. Ideal transformer at no load. Okay, at no load means we are open circuit on the no load. Okay, this is the primary winding and this is the secondary winding. When we are giving the AC supply to the primary winding, then the flux will be linking to the secondary winding. Therefore, the EMF E2 is induced. Okay, that will be connected to the load. But in this case, we are considering as the no load. Okay, no load means we are open circuited. Okay, the secondary side is open circuited. Okay, therefore, the transformer is operated at no load is equivalent to the secondary winding is kept open, open circuited, which means current in the secondary is zero. Therefore, the current in the secondary winding is zero. Okay, therefore, the current flowing through the secondary winding is zero. Okay, when the primary winding is excited, okay, if the primary winding is excited at its rated voltage, it draws a current IM. Okay, therefore, when we are giving the input supply to the primary winding, that is V1. Okay, when we are applying that V1, okay, this winding is excited. Okay, due to that excitation, that winding draws the IM current. Okay, due to that excitation, the winding draws the IM current. Okay, this IM current is called as the magnetizing current. Okay, it is denoted as IM. Okay, it is called as magnetizing current. Okay, which is 2 to 10% of the rated current. Therefore, this IM current is 2 to 10% of the rated current. Okay, this generates the magnetic flux in the core. Okay, therefore, this generates the maximum flux in the core by primary MMF N1IM, by primary MMF N1IM. Okay, as the transformer is ideal, suppose we are considering as the ideal transformer, the core losses and copper losses are zero. Okay, ideal transformer means no losses. Okay, therefore, the core losses and the copper losses are zero. And therefore, the net current taken is to be create the MMF or the flux. Okay, therefore, the net current is, total current is converted into the MMF. Okay, therefore, the total current is converted into alternating MMF or the flux. Okay, this alternating flux induces the EMF E1 and E2 in the coils, which lags by 90 degrees. Okay, therefore, when we are applying the supply voltage or the V, okay, this is the V, okay, this is the phasor diagram for the ideal transformer on no load. First taking I1 as the reference vector. Okay, due to that I1 current, the voltage, that is V1, is induced. It lags at an angle of 90 degrees. Okay, it lags at an angle of 90 degrees. Okay, this is the V1. Okay, this is the V1. Okay, not, this is the V1. V1 at an angle of 90 degrees. Okay, when the V1 is produced, okay, therefore, the flux is developed in the primary winding. Therefore, due to that V1, the flux phi is produced. Okay, due to that flux, the winding is energized. Okay, therefore, the magnetizing current that will be produced in the primary winding. Therefore, this is the magnetizing current. Therefore, that will be equal to the I1. Okay, that will be equal to the I1. Okay, due to that flux, the EMFs E1 and E2 are induced in the primary and the secondary winding. Okay, due to that magnetizing current, the flux will be produced. Okay, due to that flux, the EMF is induced in the primary and the secondary wind. That is E1 and the E2, which lags by an angle of 90 degrees. The current leads the V1 by an angle of 90 degrees and the flux lags the E1 and E2 by an angle of 90 degrees. Okay, this is the phasor diagram. Okay, this is the phasor diagram for ideal transformer on no load condition. Okay, first of all, I1 as the reference, due to that I1, V1 voltage will be produced, that will be leads by an angle of 90 degrees. Okay, therefore, some magnetizing current is produced. Okay, due to that magnetizing current, the flux phi will be produced. Okay, due to that flux, the EMFs E1 and E2 are produced. Okay, that will be lags by an angle of 90 degrees. Okay, this is also 90 degrees. Okay, that will be lags by an angle of 90 degrees. Okay, therefore, this is the ideal transformer on no load condition phasor diagram. Okay, understand? Hence, EMF C1 and E2 in the coils are in phase to each other by lags by flux. Okay, phi lags the E1 and E2 by an angle of 90 degrees. Okay, understand now? Next, construct transformer on no load condition. Okay, what is the difference between the ideal transformer and normal transformer? Ideal means there is no losses. Okay, ideal means there is no losses. Okay, due to that iron and core losses, some magnetizing currents will be produced. Okay, that is the IM. Okay, due to that magnetizing current, the flux will be produced. Therefore, this flux lags the induced EMFs, that is E1 and the E2 by an angle of 90 degrees. But when we are considering the transformer, okay, but we are considering the transformer, that means we are having the losses. Okay, that means we are having the losses. Okay, a transformer in the particular case draws an additional current, that is IW, to the magnetizing current IM. Okay, we are producing the IW also. Okay, that means wattless current, and IM is the magnetizing current. Okay, therefore, the total current from the mains I0. Okay, this is the total current from the mains, that is I0, which lags to the applied voltage by an angle of phi0. Okay, this is the IM current. Okay, due to that IM current, we are producing the wattless current, that is IW. Okay, the resultant for this IW and the IM, we are considering as, that is I0. I0 is the no load current. Okay, first of all, we draw the magnetizing current or IM, I1. Okay, due to that current, the V1 is lags, leads by an, IM is leads by an angle of 90 degrees, that is V1. Okay, as this, due to that IM, we are developing the wattless component current, that is IW. Okay, therefore, the vector sum of this current is I0. Okay, therefore, the flux phi will be produced. Okay, this lags the E1 and E2 by an angle of 90 degrees. This flux phi lags the E1 and E2 by an angle of 90 degrees. Okay, understand ma, this is the phasor diagram. Okay, now what is the difference between the ideal transformer and no load transformer? In the ideal transformer only we are obtaining the magnetizing current. Okay, due to that losses, okay, we are developing the wattless component current, that is IW. Okay, therefore the vector sum of IW and I naught, we are obtaining IM, we are obtaining the I naught, that is no load current. Okay, we are considering as the transformer at no load. Okay, then the vector sum of IW and IM, we are developing the no load current, that is I naught. Okay, then the flux phi will be produced. Okay, due to that flux, the EMF C1 and E2 are induced on each phase by leading of 90 degrees. Okay, lagging of 90 degrees. Okay, therefore, there are two components of the current, I naughts, that is active power, wattful component current, that is IW, in phase to the voltage and generate the core losses. Okay, therefore, the reactive wattless current, that is magnetizing component current, that is IM. Okay, IM is called as the magnetizing current. And IW is called as the wattful component. Okay, at no load, the input power of transformer is the iron losses. Okay, therefore, the no load angle pi naught depends upon the losses in the transformer and it is nearly equal to the 90 degrees. So that the power factor is very low. And therefore, what is the working component formula? Okay, we are writing the working component formula, that is IW. Okay, therefore IW equal to I naught cos phi naught. Okay, then what is the formula for I naught? I naught is equal to vector sum of wattless component and the magnetizing component, that is IW square plus IM square. Next we are writing, that is magnetizing component IM. Okay, therefore IM is equal to I naught sin phi naught. Okay, therefore IM is equal to I naught sin phi naught, magnetizing current. Okay, next we are writing, that is cos phi naught. Okay, power factor, that is cos phi naught. Okay, therefore the power factor cos phi naught is equal to IW by I naught, IW by I naught. Okay, what is the IW? That is wattless current. And I naught is the no load current. Okay, that will be obtained the vector sum of IW and the IM. Okay, we remember those formulas. Okay, therefore, the no load power, that is P naught. P naught equal to V1 I naught cos phi naught. Okay, this is the wattful component I naught cos phi naught. I naught is the vector sum of IW and the IM. And IM is I naught sin phi naught and power is equal to V1 I naught cos phi naught. And by using this phasor diagram, we will write the formula for power factor, that is cos phi naught. Cos phi naught equal to IW by I naught. Okay, these are the various formulas that will be related to the transformer on no load condition. No load condition, ideal transformer on no load condition and transformer on no load condition. Okay, these are the ideal transformer and transformer on no load phasor diagrams, and these are the formulas that will be related to the transformer on no load. Okay, this is the very important topic, transformer on no load condition. Okay, and in the next class we are discuss about the transformers on load conditions. Okay, thank you. We will discuss in the next class.